What's up, everyone? My name is Kyle. This is the sports tour that never ends, and I am concluding the 2023-2024 college basketball season at the Women's NCAA Division I Basketball Tournament, which is being hosted by USC and UCLA. They're both hosting the first and second round matches, which are happening today, and we are gonna go to both universities today. Why? Because I'm crazy and traveling is fun, and this is like the last time I get to do college basketball this season, so we gotta go out with a bang. I'm at USC first because they have the earlier games. The 8-seeded Kansas Jayhawks against the 9-seeded Michigan Wolverines will kick us off, and then we'll follow that up with the host, the first-seeded USC Trojans, as they take on the 16-seeded Texas A&M Corpus Christi Islanders, making their first NCAA tournament appearances. And then we're gonna go make our way to UCLA. Now, we can't watch the first game that they're hosting, but we can watch the second game, which will feature the Bruins as a 2-seed, taking on the 15-seeded California Baptist Lancers, also making their first tournament appearance. I'm just very excited. I have a mouthful of words. That was one take I just did. I'm very proud of myself. Let's go make our way inside the Galen Center on the campus at USC. I will see you guys inside and let the madness begin. Southern California, are you guys ready for March Madness as we got the Jayhawks and the Wolverines warming up in front of us? We got ourselves an exciting matchup, guys. I'm just really happy to be here. I hope you enjoy my picture with the Kansas Jayhawks. We'll see you guys for the starting lineups.
Six foot
At the end of the first quarter, the Wolverines had the lead 11-10 over the Jayhawks. It's been a pretty sloppy matchup so far. We'll see what we got for the next three quarters and if teams can make adjustments.
Dancers, Kansas or Michigan fans? Who's?
Oh, damn. Nice move. Nice.
Half away, and the USC Wolverines 32, courtesy of Kansas Jayhawks 29.
At the end of the first half, the Wolverines have the lead 32-29 over Kansas. Both teams have gotten a lot better looks, and they've been shooting the ball a lot better. It's been more of a high-scoring affair. We got two more quarters, and this should be an exciting game coming down to the wire, I hope. See you guys for the second.
Oh.
I know.
That looks like Bert.
Oh my God.
That is third quarter play.
At the end of the third, Michigan has the lead 53-44 over Kansas. They are absolutely breaking away right now, making almost every shot. We got one more quarter left. Let's see if the Jayhawks can mount a comeback or if the Wolverines can stay in front.
Oh.
How? Wow! Why is she so open? Oh my goodness! Pick her up! Oh my goodness! Oh, we're gonna do that again.
Shot clock violation.
After Kansas trailed for pretty much the whole game, they tied it up at 67. We're going to overtime, y'all.
Overtime!
What a play! Oh my God!
The Kansas Jayhawks
defeat the Michigan Wolverines in overtime, 81-72. They were trailing for most of this game. They were even down by 10 in the fourth, but they mounted a comeback and an incredible three-pointer to send the game to overtime. Kawhi Leonard ass bounce. And the Kansas Jayhawks just outplayed them in overtime, getting all the shots they wanted, and Michigan just looked gassed at the end. What a game. What a way to start off March Madness, guys. That was an awesome, awesome, awesome finish. That is why I love this tournament. We do got the USC Trojans and the Texas A&M Corpus, Cristi Islanders warming up behind me. I'm very excited because the Trojans do have Juju Watkins, one of the best freshmen in the country. They also have Kayla Padilla. That's just a Filipino shout out. Shout out Kayla Padilla, Filipinos for the win. And I will also probably be hoping for Corpus Cristi to get something going. Can they make history? Or are we gonna see USC? They are a favorite in this tournament, but you gotta play it one game at a time. See you guys in a bit.
We welcome all of you watching. Yesterday's the first day.
Oh!
Oh, shoot it. Nice.
USC's playing like they're the number one seed in this tournament. 21-4 over the Islanders. We got three more. This place is absolutely rocking. It is unbelievable right now.
Thank you.
71-41, the Trojans have broken this game wide open, looking to close it out in the last 10 minutes. The USC Trojans defeat the Texas A&M Corpus Christi Islanders 87-55 to advance to the second round of the NCAA tournament. They were very good throughout this whole game, breaking through in that third quarter with excellent shooting, defense. And again, when you are the one seed, you play like the one seed, and everything that happened today did not surprise me. Congrats to the Islanders on a great year. Between their men's team last year and the women's team this year, they both made their first ever NCAA tournament appearances. So congrats to them. Making it this far into your season is amazing and really great to see them. I love seeing small schools. As someone in San Diego who all the Division I teams are mid-majors, I love seeing other mid-majors, and this was a treat to be here. The USC Trojans and the Kansas Jayhawks will face off in the second round of the NCAA tournament. I gotta take some time because I am off to UCLA in a couple of hours. There's probably gonna be traffic getting out of here, so I'm gonna take my time. I'm gonna probably eat because I got some food before the game. Didn't eat all of it so I could have something for before UCLA. So let's take our time getting out of here. I will see you guys at Poly Pavilion in a bit. You're the coolest one. You're the coolest one I've met. Can I get a quick picture? Yeah! I was literally at UCLA 2 weeks ago. Anyways, let's go say hi to the bear, and I'll meet you guys inside Poly. So the first game we missed for the UCLA region was the 7-seeded Creighton Blue Jays against the 10-seeded UNLV Runnin' Rebels. They just wrapped up. The Creighton Blue Jays move on with an 87-73 victory. They await the winner between the Bruins and the Lancers. And I'm super excited. Yay! Welcome back inside Poly Pavilion on the campus of UCLA for the Bruins and the California Baptist Lancers. We've been here before. You know what it looks like. This is a cool place to be. I did want to bring up that this is the Lancers, not only their first ever NCAA appearance, it's also their first year of eligibility to be in the NCAA tournament. So the fact that they were able to be here on their first ever year of eligibility to make it to the tournament, that's a great up. Also the fact that they are from Riverside, California, which is only an hour away from Los Angeles. The Baptist Lancer faithful is out, and I have a feeling it's going to be pretty rocking because they are a really good student section, so it should be a fun matchup. It should be a great time.
Concludes the first quarter of play with the score UCLA 17,
At the end of the first quarter, the Bruins have the lead 17-8 over the Lancers. The Bruins are obviously the better team, but the Lancers are staying with them. They're just not as big, but they're able to get some good shots, so we'll see how the rest of this game plays out. Themselves a double digit lead, but we'll see how the second half goes. We'll see you guys for that. Quarter down, 57-38. The Bruins got off to a red hot start to start the third quarter, and they've just been in control. Although the CBU crazies have been enjoying themselves, and I've been enjoying it too. That's why I moved to their side. They're a lot louder and a lot more fun. But we got one more quarter left. Let's see if the Bruins can close it out. Gabby. Shot.
UCLA Bruins defeat the California Baptist Lancers 84-55 to advance to the second round of the NCAA tournament. They were just the better team, obviously being a two seed, and you expect them to play like a two seed. And they were just very strong, very dominant. Every time Cal Baptist got on a little bit of a run, UCLA would just zip right ahead, answer right back, and even go crazier than they were before. And they were just too much for the Lancers to handle. Congrats to Cal Baptist on an awesome year again. Their first year of eligibility for the NCAA tournament, and they qualified. That is an awesome feat for them. And, you know, as someone who's seen them a couple times play in person, that's really great for them. And I can't wait to see where that program goes in the next few years. Great for them. And that's going to conclude my three games in one day at the NCAA Women's Tournament at USC and UCLA. Which also means that concludes my college basketball traveling season for the 2023-2024 year. Wow, it's over. I can't believe it's over. This is probably the fastest it's felt that it's zipped by, and I can't believe how much I've been able to do. I didn't go to as many places as I wanted to, but I was still able to bring you guys some new places, some invitationals, and obviously the NCAA tournament, which I'm just very happy to have done because that is probably the best thing I could, you know, best way to cap off another great year of basketball. And that also concludes my third year of college basketball traveling, which is kind of insane, and I can't believe it. And, you know, I feel like UCLA is the most fitting place for that to end because this is one of my favorite venues of all my college basketball places. So yeah, so that means I get to take a break. I get to chill out for a bit. I don't want to say overwork, like this is a job. This is not a job, but I do a lot for this hobby just because I like this hobby so much, and I like to travel, I like to edit, I like to visit places, and I just like to experience everything I like to experience. So for now, I'm gonna go, I don't know, drink some water because I'm really thirsty. And that's gonna do it for my time at the NCAA Division I Women's Basketball Tournament for the year 2024 at USC's Galen Center and UCLA's Poly Pavilion. Thank you guys, as always, for watching, and I will see everyone at the next game. Peace out.